16 quarterfinal. So one win and two defeats so far. They need to win, but also win by six or more points. Well, that is the Cluj Napoca roster for tonight. Brandon Brown, Elijah Stewart, Patrick Richard. The big players this season for them. They've had big contributions from the likes of Stefan Bercevic as well. It will take a real team effort for Cluj Napoca tonight. If they win, they will finish first in the group and get home court advantage in the quarterfinals. Second, if they lose to Estenda by 5 points or fewer. Estenda's roster has some good players in there as well. Levi Randolph, Phil Booth, name just a couple. Randolph averaging over 18 points per game. Amida Brahma averaging 7 rebounds per match so far, and close to 3 blocks as well. Ghanaian, a player to watch out for, but it's Cluj Napoca who were introduced first. Who have several Romanian players on their roster. Justin Hogg is a rebound specialist. Richard, Elijah Stewart. They are important players too for Mihai Silvașan's team. Well, it's win or bust for that man's team, Dario Giurgia. They've been here before. They had to come through a play-in series against Igor Kea and came back from one game down to win 2-1 to make the round of 16 group. Not a full crowd allowed, unfortunately, tonight, but Estenda supporters allowed in. But COVID restrictions in mind, they will be making plenty of noise for Phil Booth and co. Van der Wurst, young Dutch guard for Estenda. Bratanovic, a young up-and-coming Belgian. Tan Djordjevic, the veteran point guard for Estenda. The two coaches meet then. pre-match. And what a match this could turn out to be. They're both high-scoring teams. They will be very unlikely to go back on their principles for this one. Both these sides will give it everything in attack. Cluj averaging 84 points per game, Oostende 81 in this season's BCL. Cluj the second highest scoring outfit. Oostende sixth. The officials from France, Lithuania and Italy today. Unikaha, two wins, two defeats. They are through. Cluj-Napoca, two wins and one defeat. Oostende, one win and two defeats. Could have a three-way tie in Group K. Unikaha through. We don't know if they'll finish first or second in the group, though. Well beaten by Oostende last week at this venue, the Spaniards. Well, that is the Cluj-Napoca starting five. Andrija Stipanović, the veteran center. Brandon Brown, a point guard. Patrick Richard, a very effective shooting guard, along with Karol Guzman. Kai Silvashan's team, they claimed a hugely impressive road win, 79-73 in their Group K opener in Spain against Unikaha on January 25th. So they have had success on their travels. Cluj-Napoca losing their perfect record in the group, though. 2 weeks ago, lost 86 points to 70 against Unikaha at home. Levi Randolph, Phil Booth, big scorers, Demetrius Conger. He's been playing his part since arriving this season. Dario Gerja, the Croatian in charge of the Belgian champions, hoping Oostende can pull it out of the fire again. It was do or die last week for them. They lived to fight another day. And they win by six or more this evening as well. It's going to be tense. Can keep their cool. Those play-in matches, that three-game series against Igokea will play to Oostende's advantage tonight. They know what it's like this season to be in a really crucial encounter where everything is on the line. Silvashan looks pretty calm. Cluj-Napoca head coach. Ida Braima and Sir Demetrius Conger stripped and ready to go for Oostende. Well, Cluj won the first meeting of the sides February 7th in Romania, 86-75. It was close until the final 5 minutes or so in that one. Who will come out on top this time? Zoom, 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 Zoom. Here we go then, Group K decider in the round of 16 in the Basketball Champions League. Oostende in yellow, the Belgian side have home advantage. It's the Romanian champions Cluj-Napoca on the attack first up. They're in black, Carol Guzman makes it a very good start. Well, the layup attempted but missed by Dusan Djordjevic. Three-pointer for Guzman to start with. Via Stipanović up against Amida Brajma. That could be a really good tussle between those two. And Stipanović wins the first round. Cluj-Napoca lead by five early on. Guzman able to keep that one in play. He was under pressure from Levi Randolph. Number 20 is Djordjevic. Be 39 in a few days' time, but he has still got plenty to offer. Stipanović, another veteran, 35 years of age. He's meaning business tonight. Conger got himself in a real difficult situation there, got away with it. Brajma, the hook shot. Brandon Brown. Stipanović hands it off to Guzman. That's good, under pressure from the Cuban. Brajma, a big man to get up and over. Guzman managed it. Seven years of age now, Karol Guzman. Oh, Stipanović with the steal here. A good recovery by Phil Booth in the end. Getting a steal from Stipanović. A guard like Phil Booth, it could be a good day for your side. Mihai Silvashan will be very pleased. Even more so now, Patrick Richard with a triple 10-point lead after 2.5 minutes for Cluj-Napoca. No wonder Dario Gergia has called a timeout here. Well, Gergia, pretty unhappy. Stender supporters, looking calm for now. Side trailing by 10. Holding a his face here is Djordjevic after that challenge from Brown. It gets a bit of contact there. Djordjevic a week out from his 39th birthday. He will require some treatment there. And from Belgrade, won 10 league titles in a row with Ostenda joining 2011. Going to be a review of this incident. Point run for Cluj-Napoca. Ostenda to get going in this first quarter. Well, no further action required. Bill Booth. Hey, Van der Verst. Now Breimer. It's to hurry here. He's not aware, I don't think, that he just about a second left on the shot clock. Made the shot just in time. In the corner. Is Richard dishing out a pass for Stefanovic? Doesn't work out this time. Stefanovic. Desperate to get a pass away. Guzman ran out of time. Good defending from Ostenda there. Whatever Georgia said during that timeout has worked. Stopped the 7-point run for Cluj-Napoca. Now a chance to build some momentum themselves. Shove by Stjepanović that time on Breimer. Booth screen from Breimer. The layup doesn't come off, he was fouled. Was he? Offensive foul is called. Booth crashing into Stefanovic. Brown to Guzman. Bashar. Step back. This time. Here's Conger. Difficult shot, and he comes up a little short on that one. Another foul spotted by the officials. Conger, the guilty party. Conger guarding Djordjevic. He can hit them from there. On this occasion, the floor comes Phil Booth. That could be the basket that gets Oostende going in this one. Stepanovic is being allowed to get plenty of the ball out there. Birchovic, oh, that one rattles home in the end. Last week, Birchovic got 17 points, 3 from 5 from three-point range. 2 weeks ago, I should say, in Luzhna Poka's last match. He has put them 9 points ahead here, halfway through the first quarter. Conger. I tried to feed a pass into Breimer. Richard was onto it swiftly. Birchovic tries again. Another three. Biggest lead of the game so far for the Romanian visitors. Randolph into the paint. Another missed layup. Guzman, plenty of time to weigh up the shot. Randolph has to check his run there. Booth slipping. Oh, that's a lovely pass from Birchovic to Guzman. Great layup. Luzhna Poka lead by 14. Hey, Van der Verst spots the free man in the corner. A good rebound claimed by Booth. He didn't get the foul he wanted. Brown from the wing. Birchovic. What a start to this game for Stefan Birchovic. 3 from 3, 9 points. And Luzhna Poka, they are flying in Belgium. Conger, good response. Birchovic, Richard. Green was set by Stepanovic. Richard has to go from way out. Oh! Everything going for Luzhna Poka right now. ...17-point advantage. 2 minutes left in this first quarter for Oostende. Try and eat into that massive lead. Nine three-point attempts for Luzhna Poka in this first quarter. They have made 6. And into the game, the number 18, Gael Jantunen. Did well last week, 13 points, 7 rebounds. Last week it was Oostende against Unica Malaga, who were really sharp from beyond the arc, 13 from 21. 62% of their three-point shots. That's an 18-point win. That reaction from Georgia says a lot. Nightmare first quarter. Two free shots missed by Jantunen. In his defense, he is only on court a matter of seconds. Offensive foul this time. Austin Hogg. Looks over to the officials as if to say, "E." Elijah Stewart is in. That's bad news. What a player he is off the bench. What a season he's having in the Basketball Champions League. Hey, Van der Wurst. Now Booth. Back to Van der Wurst. 8 seconds on the shot clock. Freeman fouled. Was Servas Bejsaat. Bejsaat turned 23. A few days ago. He has no luck with his foul shots either so far. Belgian needs to compose himself here. Djordjevic is patched up, his team back to within 16 points now. Shah to Guzman. Travelling, that was a little bit sloppy from a man who's played very well in this first quarter. Karol Guzman with 7 points to his name. Verse now. Booth. And aggressive defending again, and it's forced a turnover. Easy layup. Nandor Kuti with it, just on court. Booth. He was looking to draw contact. Now Stewart's Kuti. Good grab. Much needed. Jantunen doing well. Here's Van der Wurst. Booth. Jantunen with another rebound. That is brilliant play. Clear foul there by Bejsaat. He would have been well aware that Ostenda had only made a couple of fouls in this first quarter, so no harm done for that challenge on the Sharp. How about that from Jantunen, though? Finland international making it a 3-point run for Ostenda. They can keep Cluj-Napoca out here. Would be very welcome. Bejsaat. Oh, wow. How did he do that? And please welcome the winners. Patrick Richard finishing the first quarter with a flourish. Looked like Phil Booth had done enough here. Look again. Incredible. Point lead for Cluj-Napoca through 10 minutes. What a first quarter it has been for them. Oh, Patrick Richard. Two spectacular three-pointers. He's got three in total. 7 from 11 from three-point range. We can look back on some of those spectacular plays. Guzman with the first of 7 three-pointers. Stipanović was very good early on. It was a 5-point lead without reply for Cluj-Napoca before Georgievich got a basket. Stipanović replying straight away. And then Richard composing himself. That was a 10-point lead, 12-2. Dario Zsuzsa wondering what more could go wrong. The answer was a lot. Breimer replied with his one basket. Got it back to 12-6. Berchevich would take over his three-point shooting. 31-12. We head into the second quarter here. Randolph. Jump shot. It's no good. 35 points for the number two last week against Unicaja. That's a good steal from Levi Randolph. He took it off Kuti. And Ostenda need a lot more of those to get back into this game. But it's a good start. Stewart all alone. Well, Jantunen finding space this time. Brandon Brown, Hogg coming through. Tit for tat at the start of this second quarter then. Van der Verst, that's a bit of a wild pass. It's a talented player, Kay Van der Verst, but he's not the only Ostenda player tonight who is struggling a little early on. Of course, things went badly from the start with Dusan Georgievich getting that head injury so early in the game. He's back out there now, guarding Brown. Stipanović is free. Fancies the go at Basart, and that is why. Georgievich. The Basart three, because he's hardly going to attempt a three. This man will, though. Announcing himself in the game is Olivier Trois-Fontaine. Stipanović enjoying himself out there, using all his experience. 35 years of age now, Andrija Stipanović. And he drew the foul from Basart that time.
Mm-hmm.
18 points in it. Cluj-Napoca lead, looking to extend that lead now. Brown. He missed out. Brandon Brown averaging 16.6 points per game in this season's BCL. Yet to get a basket tonight, though. Brown gets his chance and takes it from the free throw line. First year with Cluj. He had injury problems at the start of the season, returned in November, has not looked back since then. And Silver Sands team lead by 20. Georgievich, mid-ranger. Brown goes again. Georgievich fouls him this time. Last week against Unicaja, this venue. Denda led by 8. After the first quarter, they were pegged back in the second, led by 1 at halftime, up by 3. Going into the final quarter, they outscored Unicaja by 15 points, 27-12, won by 18 in the end. Need a big performance from here to make the quarterfinals. There's an official review. Dustin Hogg, number 22, the Cluj-Napoca player involved. Hogg is from Yonkers in New York State. He's a hard man to get a handle on. Pretty sharp elbows, as Jantanen has just found out. Got 9 points, 7 rebounds, 2 assists and 3 steals against Ostenda back on February 7th, at 86-75 win. The boos will tell you that Georgia's side have been penalized here. Winning his battle with Jantanen. Averaged double figures in 3 seasons consecutively before he joined Cluj in the summer from NSC, a Russian side. It's only 2 points the lead. Well, there was the first foul. That was worth 2 shots. That's what they've decided. They called the foul initially, Antonin's challenge on Hogg. Then Hogg made contact with the elbow. So finally, Antonin, at the fourth attempt, makes a free throw. Randolph, traffic in front of him. Good rebound. Jantanen is there. Johannes Bratanović had the three-point shot that caused all that panic underneath the basket. It was Trois-Fontaines who went up first. Jantanen, who had the second goal. The foul was called on Trois-Fontaines. He gets two free shots. And he gets them both. Brown is out. Richard back in. Richard. This out to Kuti. Cluj-Napoca yet to lose consecutive games in the BCL. They are looking good to extend that particular run. Hogg, a couple more free throws. He's good in this situation. Commentator's curse, of course, misses the second one. Five points and three rebounds for Dustin Hogg so far. Trois-Fontaines has 5 points as well from the bench. Stewart was fouled out the last time these sides met. Got 17 points as well, but... called for that one. Georgia a little happier, but his side have made five fouls already in this quarter. They're under serious pressure so early in the piece. Jantanen lost his man. Timeout called. Good little run for Ostenda. He needs more of that. Georgievich finding Jantanen. He's up to 7 points, the number 18. This is interesting. Gilvasan telling his players to target Dusan Georgievic. We've seen that before. He is on two fouls already, the number 20. Drummers and Jantanen doing their best to push Ostenda to victory. Remember, they need to win by six. Nothing less than that will do for the Belgian champions, so they have a long way to go. They're 24 points down on their target at the moment. Stipanović, Hogg, good play again. Georgievich trying to wriggle away from Kuti, get some help from Bratanović that time, but found Stipanović in the way. Georgievich for three. Trois-Fontaines. Offensive foul. Offensive foul. Anton Fontaine taken out. Booth is back in. 26-year-old American. It's one from six from the field today so far, Phil Booth. 10 minutes on courts. He needs to start landing some shots. Stepanovic, that was a bit dramatic from him. Randolph. Fadeaway is good. That was not looking good for Levi Randolph for a moment. Never doubt him. Stender now outscoring Kluzhnikova 14-13 in this second quarter. Stewart from the corner. Looked like Silvasano's coach was happy with that choice. Randolph. Well, he was grappling. But Stewart at the end of this one. And Brandon Brown sent back in. Hogg and Kuti go off for Kluzhnikova. Berchevich was so good in the first quarter. Then as well as Levi Randolph, 29-year-old from Madison, Alabama. Misses from a free throw. Georgia. Be so frustrating for him. That's two from seven tonight for his side. Randolph gets the second. Guzman. Don't look that time. 7 3-point shots from 11 in the first quarter. Kluzhnikova have had one attempt in the second. Here's Guzman. And there's Richard. Well, just when Ostende cutting the gap a little bit, there was a costly turnover. Georgievic was a little unsure. And Kluzhnikova have a 4-on-2 break that they have wasted. Nine turnovers for Ostende. We just witnessed the fifth for Kluzhnikova. Timeout called. 19 points, the difference between the two sides. Kluzhnikova have only missed 7 of 24 shots tonight. 10 from 23 successful for Ostende. They've had 4 offensive rebounds. Not punishing Kluzhnikova enough. 5 free throws successful from 10 attempts. Big 3.5 minutes to come here for the Belgians. Here is Booth. Oh, that was good. But Guzman has been called for goaltending. What a run from Booth. He can't block a shot if it's on the way down. And Ostender get the points there. Stepanovic. Breimer is with him. Richard. Now Guzman. He realized time was against him. He had to take on the shot. A pretty good effort in the end. Guzman, that is lovely. Stepanovic with the assist. Here is Conger for Ostender. Long three, doesn't come off. There, Stepanovic, 6 points, two assists. Here he is again. Bercevic! Well, finally, he has missed a three-point shot. Randolph does as well. Booth. Jantunen. Good play. Good finish from the Finn. 17-point game. Bishop has 11 points. Guzman, 9. Stepanovic taking on Breimer. Traveling. Four-point run for Philo Ostender. They could maybe double that. Maybe make it a 10-point run. Give them something to cling on to going into the second half. That is grabbed by Guzman. Richard gives it back to him, and Karol Guzman gets the dunk. Booth. Jantunen can't make the three. Conger thought about it. Booth. Fouled. But it didn't drop. Will be two free throws rather than one chance to make it a three-point play. That was the pass from Booth, picked off by Guzman. Here you go, says Richard. Well, Phil Booth, he's 6 years of age now, the man from Baltimore, Maryland. Season his first overseas experience. Well, Stender will hope that they can settle and emerge in the second half a different side. They have left so many points behind them. They trail by 18. Mihai Silvesan, though, said after the first game between these two, basketball matches won by a team that works harder for the full 40 minutes. It's not who wins the first quarter, the second, or the third.
It's not moment to start to be hurt. It's not moment to start to be frustrated. It's moment to be clear. To be clear and execute. Two times, one. First one. Shirt to shake. With Karel here. Karel, first. Look here, maybe you have it, but don't move. If not, continue, go with that. Come in ahead, stay corner, stay here, play. Second one, if you have, don't play people.
It is not a time to be frustrated. It's a time to be clear in what you want to do, was the message. The coach of the Romanian champions, Cluj Napoca. This, their debut season in the BCL. They came through qualifying, and they are not too far away from making the quarterfinals. A win here, they will go through. And it's clear cut. If they win, they go through first. There's Brime over the big block on Richard. Brimer judged that one well. So Richard, message to him, you can't have it all your own way tonight. Certainly had a lot of fun out there so far, Patrick Richard. 11 points, 4 assists, 3 rebounds as well. First block of the night. For Amida Brima, the two number 35s coming together. Stipanović, a little unfortunate. Booth into the paint. Guzman swatting that one away. Jantanen was in the corner, hoping to make a 3-point shot here. Randolph, Conger couldn't get the shot away. Jantanen did, he gets the rebound, he gets 2 points. Well, he has been the best player for Ostenda tonight. Mikael Jantanen up to 11 points, 4 rebounds as well. Richard, they survive this time. Or do they? Was a foul called right at the end. Looks like it. And they are reviewing this one. Time is a factor, of course. Sharp indicated that there might have been a foul here. Uti was the player on the ball for Cluj Napoca. Was the number 8 fouled? That could be a bad blow to Ostenda. They've had a few already tonight. Oh, I think that could well be called a foul. It was Booth throwing his arm in. Georgievich's face says it all. Georgievich's as well. 2 free shots as a result of a foul from Phil Booth, the second of the night. So we aren't done. They had it back to 16 points, but Silvasan and Cluj Napoca, they can hurt Ostenda once again before halftime here. Nandor Kuti, 25 years of age, the Romanian, playing for the Romanian champions. He waits his turn. Another check.
Reclame microfoons op onder bussen plaatsing naar Leiden op 16 april.
A reminder, if you've just joined us, any other result than a win by 6 points for Oostende means they are out. Bootsy misses the first shot for Cluj-Napoca. And he misses the second as well, so no harm done for Oostende. Silvesan, though, will be by far the happier coach. Oostende outscoring Cluj-Napoca 22-19 in the second quarter, but still a long way back for them. At the break, they trail by 16. Dario Gerges' team losing this one 50 points to 34 at the moment. What a first quarter in particular, Cluj-Napoca in Belgium. They have 1 foot in the quarterfinals. Jantinen with 11 points, Guzman and Richard on 11 as well. And Bercevic with 3 triples in the first quarter. He has 9 points for the visitors. Lots of good plays to look back on. Phil Booth. I'll be hoping for more from him. 5 points. It's 1 assist. Richard and Bercevic. They are flourishing out there, as is Guzman. 11 points for the number 0. Jantinen, the go-to man for Oostende. He has 11 points, 4 rebounds. Richard, well, what a show he's put on. 11 points, 3 from downtown. Jantinen doing his very best to keep Oostende in this game. Randolph, 35 points last week, just 5 so far here. Elijah Stewart with just 1 basket. Jantinen fed by Van der Verst on that last one. It's been very good for Dario Gerges' side. Stepanovic has been a real handful. 6 points, 2 rebounds, 2 assists, 2 offensive rebounds for the big number 13. Silvesan in his side drain 7 three-pointers in the first half. 7 of them in the first quarter, none in the second. Been Jantinen against Cluj-Napoca at times. Dustin Hogg, good contribution. 7 points from the bench, 3 rebounds, 2 assists for the number 22. And Stepanovic linking up well with Guzman. Great scores, most of them from Cluj-Napoca. Was a sloppy pass from Phil Booth. 10 turnovers in the first half for Oostende. And Richard, well, he was blocked by Breimer, but that happens to a lot of players. Mida Breimer, the Ghanaian. Yeah, pretty well so far. Well, Richard, clock was against him there, did not matter. That was just 1 of 3 three-pointers he made. 11 points in total, 4 assists. This one, ridiculous at the end of the first. He has a steal as well, Richard. Sensational stuff from the number 35. For Cluj-Napoca. Look at Phil Booth's reaction, the number 5. Couldn't do any more. That is only 2-point score. Richard fed by Guzman that time. And Oostende, well, Only one man really doing kind of work that's required for the Belgian champions. 11 points for Janssen, and he's only missed two shots from the field. Crucially, though, he's missed three of his four free throw attempts. He could have had an even better half. 11 points in 12 minutes on court, two offensive rebounds, one steal as well. Needs a lot of help from his teammates in the second half. Ostender in a hole. They need a huge second half performance. Jantunen needs to keep this up. Some of his teammates need to produce something similar as well. ...31-12 was the first quarter score in Cluj-Napoca's favour. Ostender have pulled them back by 3 points. It is 34-50 at halftime. Strasbourg with 18 points to Sombathé's 12. Pearl, what a pass! What a play! Cavaliera's 4 points and 5 rebounds, one steal as well.
It has to be quick. Ragland. Ragland through the gap, pops it up. Oh, that is beautiful. Kaiser was there waiting. What about this? Worth another look. Ragland. Kaiser soaring like an eagle on the alley-oop. Beautiful basketball.
As well, and now kick, pick and ball here. Yes, alley-oop. Oh, baby! Cameron Sanity, one more time. But look at this. Cameron Sanity with a one-handed alley-oop. Well, Mr. Oliver. Oliver Airline.
Now fallen to eighth in the league. 12, 10 they are. Oh, what a stop by Simmons. That was on the way in. It's percentage, more than half. How about that for a stop by Simmons? Jones, well placed, ready to dunk it. Oh, no, you don't.
Piñero flags in for the dunk. The lead has gone back to 13. Look at Piñero. And when he is playing well, he is fun to watch.
So we're moments away from the second half. Send up with it all to do in this final Group K fixture. Brandon Brown gets us started again. Cluj-Napoca, his team, leading by 16. Foul early on by Brima. Stipanović had a very good first half. 6 points, 2 offensive rebounds, 2 assists, and a steal. This is first up. And misses the second. Georgevic patched up and ready. He hopes to lead a remarkable comeback in the second half. Ostenda have to win by 6 to go through to the quarterfinals. That'll help. Brown gets himself free with the help of a screen from Stipanović. Randolph got good balance there. That one out off Georgevic. Ostenda alternating between wins and defeats in their 9 home games in the BCL since the beginning of last season. Scored 85 plus points in each of their last 2 BCL games, but haven't done it 3 times in a row. Cluj-Napoca on the attack. It's Guzman to Richard. That doesn't work out. Oh, Georgevic arriving right on cue. Richard. Stipanović. Backing into Brima. Was there a foul? There was. Georgevic starting this second half very well, but he is the man who has been penalised here. He's got the first 4 points of the third quarter. He's got Ostenda's second foul. A handoff from Brown is no good. Georgevic charging down the floor. Booth is free. Booth makes 3. That's more like it from Ostenda. Georgevic using his experience. Knew it was time to up the tempo. Held off Brown. Found the right pass. Booth found the right finish. It's a 9-point run going back at the end of the second for Ostenda. Tildesan calling the timeout. His side have conceded 7 without reply at the start of this third quarter. Thank you. Well, Ostende have been here before. They had to win by six away to Strasbourg at the end of the regular season to get second place in their group. Only won by 1 point in the end in that one. High-scoring affair. They have to win by six again. They've given themselves some hope now. Offensive foul by Stepanovic will help them out as well. The foul on Randolph. Randolph to Djordjevic. Serbian backing into Brown and taking too many steps. That could be just the little moment that Cluj-Napoca needed. Settle down in this third quarter. Richard, the paint. Take the shot though. Jantunen, Randolph, Jantunen looking to add to his 11 points, unable to do so. Brown, Stepanovic, Cluj-Napoca yet to score in the third. Phil Booth, fouled by Guzman. Belgians are fighting hard. Cluj-Napoca perhaps starting to feel the pressure. Two shots to come for Booth. Georgia can't believe the lack of success his side have had tonight from free throws. Second one is good for Booth. 8 point game. They have halved the deficit. Start of the third quarter. Good pass, Brown. Just about hanging on, goes for three. He was fouled. Berčević getting involved where perhaps he shouldn't have. Breimer was out to Brandon Brown. Officials sorting it out now. Berčević. Just climbing over Breimer, it seemed. Made contact with his leg as he did so. Wasn't a bit naughty. The number 14, Stefan Berčević. That's worth reviewing again. I don't think there was a foul. As he made the shot, it was almost right after. Here we go. Mitrovic comes over. Can't tell from that angle. In that, I don't think. And they have decided, it seems that Berchevic was innocent. We'll resume with Brandon Brown having two free shots. 25 points he got when these sides last met. 6 3-pointers out of 10 attempts he made then. Quieter so far, Brown. He's got the bug as well. Lots of missed free throws. But was fouled when he attempted a three-pointer. This is the last two. So 3 from 5 for Brandon Brown. Foul shots tonight. Has finally got the first point for Cluj-Napoca in the third quarter. Only made those 3 free throws overall tonight. Jantunen had no time to think about that one. Instinct working out well for Jantunen there with the shot clock against him. 6 points between the sides. How have Ostenda managed this? What a comeback. Richard thought about the three, bounce pass to Hogg. Home fans not happy. Georgievich. A third foul for Dusan Georgievich tonight. So, in fact, it's his fourth. And that could be a vital factor in this game because he started the third quarter really well, got 4 points himself, an assist too. Hogg makes it a 3-point play. And he makes it a 9-point game again. Well, it's a big chance for Van der Verst who's come in for Georgievich. That's going to do his confidence the world of good. First basket for Kay Van der Verst. Brown silences the crowd. Van der Verst taking his time. Good pass to Brima. Jantunen makes it. They're getting it to the right man all the time now. Jantunen, back-to-back threes for him. 17 points in total. Brown spots Berchevich. No foul. Richard, the layup, missed, but it does drop. Jesus. 13 points for Richard. Come on, That was great work from Jantunen, but unfortunately for him, little feint found a shot. Able to get in. 9-point lead again for Cluj-Napoca. Van der Verst for three. Standing start, no problem. Gurchevich free in the corner again. He overcooks that one. Phil Booth commits the foul. Well, Breimer loves a block. 2.7 he averages per game. This one not counting. There was a foul by Booth before that. Third foul for Booth. Rashad goes to the line. Rashad, the American from Louisiana. Romania, well now. Played in New Zealand and Italy and Spain. Coolest man out there. 8-point game again. Randolph. Van der Verst away from Brown. Breimer did brilliantly. Van der Verst has another go. Oh, almost. That would have brought the house down. Phil Booth. Seeing it rattle out. Shard calls for a screen. And a foul by the number 35. Crashed into Jantunen. Timeout called. Georgia will be happy. 19 points this side have scored in this third quarter. They've conceded 11. This game far from over. But remember, Ostenda need to win by at least 6 to go through, along with Unicaja from Group K.
They will switch us on the pitch. Go again with the zipper. Open line here, four. Roll there. Hey, let me look in here, high low. Or they will come open line here. Pass back and attack. You sit on your back. Okay? Listen.
This is the way. This is the way.
Jantunen making 2 3-pointers. Van der Verst making one as well in this third quarter. They're finally coming to life from that sort of distance. 6-14 now for Ostenda. 3-point land. And Georgia said the last defeat against Cluj wasn't an 11-point game. The last 5 minutes of that one, his side falling away. Cluj made some lucky points, he felt. Breimer with a slam. Six points between the sides again. Stewart. Hogg. Long range for a player like him. Breimer grabbing the rebound. Good signing he was, the man from Accra. 28 years of age now, high school in Miami. The University of Connecticut, the big number 35 though. has been penalised here. Playing Puerto Rico before moving to Belgium in November. Stewart can't make the three. Well, 3-point shooting for Klushnopolka was exceptional in the first quarter. Seven they made. They've made one since then. 8 from 19 now. Vandeverst, the long three. Good board. Grabbed by Stewart. Richard makes it look so easy. Seventeen points for him. 8 points the difference. Bender on the attack. Randolph fouled by Hogg. Georgievich is off with four fouls. Dustin Hogg. He has three fouls now, along with Elijah Stewart and Brandon Brown. Reimer goes off, replaced by Servus Weishart. 51 seconds left in what has been a really dramatic third quarter, an excellent third quarter for the Belgian champions Oostende. It can still get better for them, because Randolph, for starters, has two free throws now. But his best tally in the BCL last week in that win over Unicaja, 35 points. Got 20 points and four assists against Cluj back on February 7th in that 86-75 defeat. Fontaine comes back in. 6 point game. Stefanovic back out there for Klushnopolka. Hands it off to Stewart. Well, he missed his window there. There was an opening if he fancied a shot. He'll have to take on a tougher one now. He was fouled. Basehart doesn't like the call. Stewart had no time to work with here. Stewart's another man from Louisiana in the United States, was playing for Śląsk Wrocław in Poland last season, played in Finland before that. Ice cold that time. Stewart with 4 points now. Last attack for Oostende in this third quarter. Conger. Basehart. Oh, Stepanovic finishes off well for Klushnopolka. Not a great third quarter for them, but that is a good boost. They lead by 8 going in to the final 10 minutes. Bounce pass from Richard, finding Stepanovic before that. Van der Wurst getting it to Conger. And then Basehart just rolling it in. Well, Oostende were down by 19 points after the first quarter. They won the second by 3. The third, 25-17. They still trail by 8. Remember, have to win by 6. Go through to the quarterfinals. Djordjevic, he led the charge at the start of this third quarter. A couple of early baskets from him. 6 points, 3 assists, but crucially 4 fouls for the number 20. Phil Booth getting an assist there, his second. Djordjevic timing his run well. Tilda San, the Romanian coach of Cluj-Napoca, would have been a little bit concerned. Phil Booth starting to find his range. Getting a 3-pointer there. Djordjevic returning the favor. Booth with 9 points now, 5 rebounds. Jantanen, top scorer for Oostende with 17. The number 18 gets it started. Huge fourth quarter to come. Only a victory by 6 points or more will do for the Belgian side. And a lot of things have gone against them tonight. That's another. Guzman fouled by Kay van der Verst, at least according to the officials. Gerger has had a complaint, a gripe or two, a moan or two after a few matches this season. And the Oostende coach, 46 years of age, from Zadar in Croatia. Belgian manager as well. Hoping that, well, this fourth quarter goes a lot better from here on out for his side. Guzman certainly exaggerated the contact. Official review ongoing, though. Better angle here. I don't know. Not much there, surely. No, call stays. Little unlucky there, Van der Verst. Defense. Well, against Suni Kaha, Cluj-Napoca were level going into the final quarter. Stipanović with the up and under there. He has been really impressive tonight. He finished the third quarter well with a late basket. He has got an early one here. 10-point game again. Stipanović with 10 points. Good pass. Trofontaine. 3 points. Still time for Oostende to turn this around. Almost a steal. Stewart has 5 seconds to work with here. Stipanović, Hogg, way out. Great pass, foul, and it counts. What a play from Oostende. 2 points for Jantanen. and a chance to add another. Van der Wurst with the pass of the game, and Jantunen did the rest. Hogg missing out. The clock against him. Van der Wurst knew that Cluj-Napoca were a little unsettled at the back that time. Jantunen makes it 20 points for the Finn, who is flying tonight. This is the closest that Oostende have been since the first quarter. Since the very start of the match, really. Seven-2 was the lead for Cluj-Napoca early on. They pulled away. They've stayed well out in front ever since. Now they might be getting a little anxious out there. Again, Brown. He was taking the long way around. The Oostende defense performing admirably here. Well, Georgia, the Oostende coach, was right up with the play there. He knew that Brown had overstepped. Van der Wurst has to be careful. Got the pass away. Conger. And Beisart. Van der Wurst arriving. Beisart goes it alone. Unlucky. Richard. Brown. Guzman to Richard. 4 seconds on the clock here. Whistle sounds again. Now it's Cluj-Napoca that are having all the problems. Van der Wurst misses out. Oh, how many points have they left behind now? We'll restart though. Chad, he penalized for dissent there. 10 free throws from 18 for Oostende. They have had their chances. They've drawn lots of fouls. Van der Wurst looking to draw another. But no, this one goes the way of Cluj-Napoca. Guzman doing a good job guarding Van der Wurst right up in his face without stepping across the line. Just feel it was a crucial couple of minutes, a couple of plays there for Oostende. They've missed two chances to get closer to Cluj-Napoca now. Another foul called. This one against Conger. Guzman holds on. Have to be careful now, Oostende. Four team fouls. Oh, good steal from Van der Wurst. Poffontaine driving in. And it came off him last. How about this from the youngster, Kay Van der Wurst? super steal. And Trois-Fontaine running into Brown and Stepanovic. Brandon Brown fancies his chances against Basehart, but what's going on? Have to keep your eye on everything now. Every part of the court. Fourth foul for Trois-Fontaine. That one was on Stepanovic. 8 points for Olivier Trois-Fontaine, but nearly done for the night. One more foul and he's out. Third time lucky for Andrija Stepanović. Had missed two free throws tonight. Six-point game again. A reminder, Cluj-Napoca with a win go through top of the group. Unicaja Malaga will be second. Deal. The pass from Van der Verst not getting through. Brown. Oh! Wonderful pass for Stepanović. He fouls Jantunen. Clash of knees. Sore one for Jantunen. Fair player though, Stepanović. He got a nudge from Basehart, in fairness to the man from Bosnia Herzegovina. Trois-Fontaine is out. Big 6 minutes to come for Levi Randolph and Georgievich, who are back in. Conger, Georgievich did really well except for the finish. If they weren't targeting the number 20 before, they will now because Georgievich is on four fouls. Stepanović! No stopping him! Birčević with a great feed. Stepanović doing the rest. Timeout called. Stepanović, 14 points he has for the night. Four rebounds, two assists.
Hey, hey, all of them. Two flash with Levi. Savas, come here, Mick, Mitch. Hey. Use it. Read it. Go back. Hey.
Miguel Buzan, the assistant coach of Stenda, having a word with one of the officials on the way out there. Stenda were in action on Sunday domestically. They beat the Dutch side Feyenoord in the BNXT League, first season of that competition, which involves Belgian and Dutch teams. Big effort required in the final 5 minutes for the Belgian champions. Randolph to Georgievic, taking on Guzman, fouled by Guzman. This is where experience comes into play. Georgievic has had a very good second half here. Mustenda have to beat Cluj by 17 or more to finish top of this group. I think that is going to happen. They'll take a win by six or more to go through second. Final day in Group K. Unicaja Malaga already through. Who is joining them in the final eight? Six points between the teams. Ostende need to win by six or more to qualify. Stepanovic, Bercevic, Guzman for three. Conger. You need some three-pointers or some three-point plays, you'd imagine. Ostende. Here's Randolph. That'll do. A chance of a three-point play now. Randolph away from Brown. Got the contact, got the 2 points as well. Into double figures. Levi Randolph. 3 point gain. And both sides now have made five team fouls. In this quarter, there's another from Basart on Stepanovic. Two free throws to come for the big man. Clever turn. He has been sensational tonight, the number 13, 6 foot 10. But he's put in a really great all-round team performance here. 14 points, 4 rebounds, 2 assists, 2 steals as well, just 3 turnovers. And Georgia, he had too much to say there. Stewart at the line. Makes the first shot. Makes the second. Georgia probably senses this game is very much in the balance now, in danger of slipping away from his side. Richard, what a pass! Bercevic can't make the shot. Conger. Randolph. Great dribbling, not a great finish. Gets the rebound, gets 2 points. Persistence paying off for Randolph. Klusz Napoca won 5 from 6 in the regular season. They won Group G ahead of Zorusha Fak of Turkey, Brindisi of Italy. Their coach, Nihai Silvasan, played for the club. He's from Cluj-Napoca. His whole career with Cluj-Napoca before taking over as head coach in 2016. Can his side hold on here? Looking for a third win from four in this group. Gantanen holds his hand up here. He has fouled Stepanovic. Every point being celebrated now. Well, 2 from 2 that time. 5-point lead again for Cluj-Napoca. Georgievich. Oh, that was unlucky. That was brilliant play. Deserved a basket. Off the glass, but that kind of night. Remember, they trailed by 22 points at one stage. Stender making a real match of it, but Berčević and Cluj-Napoca in danger. Pulling clear now. Georgievich needing help, gets it from Jantanen. 10 seconds on the shot clock. Into the final 3 minutes of this Group K encounter. Conger for three. That surely had to drop. No hurry for Brown, the Romanian champions, using up plenty of time, and Brown playing it off for Berčević. Great play, he upped the tempo at just the right time, unselfish as well. Well, those visiting supporters are making plenty of noise now. They're almost there. Well, they've had a great journey in the BCL this season, Ostenda. 3 wins and 3 defeats in the regular season. Phil Booth starring as they beat Igokea in a play-in series, coming back to win that 2-1. Last time when they met Cluj in Romania, it was the fourth quarter where they lost it. This time, gave themselves too much to do. A disastrous opening 10 minutes. Randolph has that one swatted away. Stewart, aggressive. Berčević was there as well. Shalt not pass. Booth. Out of time and out of luck. Hogg. Stewart. Trying to help himself to 3 points. Oh, good pass, good take. Hunger was fouled. Oh, my mistake, it was goaltending the call. Well, Cluj-Napoca have lasted the course in this one. They had that huge advantage after 10 minutes. Credit Ostenda, they kept chipping away at it, but the Romanians had too much in the end. Randolph. Oh, good steal from Hogg. 3-on-1 here. Hogg goes alone. And why not? 12 points for him. He's had a fine game. There's another example of some great defending from Cluj-Napoca. Stewart with the block. Well, that would have been a spectacular finish, but they have done more than enough tonight. Cluj-Napoca in the end. It did get tight for Silver Sands team. Those fans will be so happy. Worth the journey, I'm sure. Some of them maybe traveled from closer in, but 2,000 kilometers, Cluj-Napoca to Ostend, from Romania to Belgium. And the journey will go on for the Romanian champions. Stewart pads out the score a little more. It was a 3-point game with 4:23 to play. An incredible effort from Ostenda to get that close. But they could not rein Cluj-Napoca in. They go through. And they go through as group winners. Quarterfinals, here we come. What a magical trip this has been. For Cluj-Napoca this season in the BCL. Great effort again from Silver Sands team. What a start. 31-12, they took the first quarter. That gave them the platform to go on and win this one by 11 points. Richard, well, he was pivotal again, just like last time in Romania when these sides last met. And Cluj-Napoca, back then they won by 11 points as well. The celebrations can well and truly start now. Real disappointment for Dario Giurgia, his side so entertaining. Cluj-Napoca, big entertainers as well in the Basketball Champions League. What a night for the Romanians. They have won it 85-74. Ostenda are out. Cluj-Napoca go through along with Unicaja Malaga to the quarterfinals. Well, they just outlasted Ostenda in the end. That sensational first quarter. Oh, thrilling for the travelling support. And it turned into a tight enough game in the end, but Ostende could get no closer than 3 points, and they lost by 11, despite 20 points from Jantunen. Well worth the entrance fee and the journey. This is what it's all about. What a connection between the supporters and the team. What a season they're having. For Cluj-Napoca. Look what it means. Well, Cluj-Napoca top Group K. They get home court advantage in the quarterfinals. Unicaja goes second, and they go through as well. Promete sadly dropping out. It was a three-team group in the end. Filu Ostende almost made it with the help of a win over Unicaja last week, but this was a bridge too far for them. Make no mistake, Cluj-Napoca will take some beating. Well, we hope you enjoyed the action. Another cracking night and plenty more to come this week. A few more matches ongoing and more to come on Wednesday as well. Then it will be the quarterfinals. From myself, Mark Rodden, it's goodbye for now.